Hi, in this video tutorial, we'll be covering some of the new edit features of Proloquo2Go 2. If you tap on the pencil button, you will enter edit mode. Under the first tab, Arrange, we have three options to add a button, add an action, or add a folder. So let's go ahead and add a button. I'm going to do Proloquo2Go. Now you can see Proloquo2Go was added to my home screen. The next button I'm going to show you how to add is an action button. Tap on action. Now we need to tap on the action, so we have four options. Add text to message window. We'll add the text to the message window without speaking it. This is the same as a regular button. Speak text immediately. We'll speak the text without inserting it into the message window. This can be helpful for creating quick interjections. Speak message window will speak the message in the message window. It is a substitute for tapping the message window to make it speak. And the last one is clear message window. We'll clear the message window. It is a substitute for the backspace button in the message window. Let's go ahead and add an action button to clear the message window. I'm just going to tap on clear message window, go back to add a home. And it already defaultly put a symbol with an X in there, so that'll be fine. I'm gonna hit done. And now as you see, you can't see it. If you scroll down, you'll see that it has placed it on the next page. And the reason I know it placed on the next page is because there's a blue line that has separated from the first page to the second one. I can easily move it by tapping on it while I'm in edit mode, and then tapping on another button and hit the swap button, which is also a new feature in Proloquo2Go 2.0 or later. I'm going to hit done. Okay, now I'm going to build a sentence.
What is Proloquo2Go?
And now if I want to erase that message or the message window, I just have to tap on clear message, the action button we just made. So before,
what is Proloquo2Go?
A user had to use the delete button in the message window to delete. And if you hit it once, it only deleted one, and you had to double tap to clear the whole message window. Now, by making one action button to clear the message window, a user can easily clear the message window, or if they have a keyguard, they can now have it incorporated inside their keyguard. Go back in the edit mode, and the last add feature is add a folder. I'm going to tap on add a folder. I'm going to create a new folder, and this time I'm going to take a picture from my photo library by tapping tap to edit and choose a picture and go into my camera roll. I'm going to create one for traveling. Hit done. And now again, it has added it in the second page. As I can see, if I scroll down, there's a blue line that separates the page one from the page two. And all I have to do is tap on the folder, and I can swap it onto my first page simply by tapping another button and hitting the swap feature. Okay, now hit done. And we're gonna scroll back up to the first page. And now I can see that I've created a travel folder that is empty and ready for me to add more buttons. So I'm going to edit, add button. We're gonna go to San Diego. Of course, we're going to do the Chargers. In Proloquo2Go 2.0 and later, you can change individual buttons, characteristics such as background color, border color, display, and visibility. Let's go back in edit mode and tap on the property tab now. If you notice, there's a little triangle at the left side. This is to expand the window. We have not selected an item, so there's no properties yet. But as soon as we tap on an item, we will now get options to change the properties of that individual button. So, like I said, now we can change this button independently by going into the button properties and clicking on background color. And let's change this one to blue background and then change the border color to like a yellow. And let's say we're done with that button. And let's say we wanted to change our clear message action button that we just did. And let's say we want to make it just the image. So it doesn't say clear message, it just has an X. You can also change the visibility of each button by hiding or dimming the button. If I tap on the button not, because it looks just like the X clear one, I don't want my user to be confused, so I'm going to hide, make it hidden, so now when I go out of edit, it will be a blank spot. But also I want to show you another feature of visibility on the More button, and this one is to dim it, which means the user will still be able to see it, but will not be able to touch it to speak it. Hiding buttons is helpful for introducing vocabulary. You can start with an advanced vocabulary and hide most of the buttons, which does not affect the arrangement of the buttons. As the user advances, you can show the buttons gradually and then keep the general layout of the vocabulary organization. Dimming buttons is helpful if you want a button that the user can visually see but won't be able to access. For example, if you're out of a particular food, you can dim that button to indicate that you're out of that food. So let's go out of edit mode, and you can see that the button that we hid is now gone. You can't see it, but it's still there. If you go back and edit, you'll be able to see it. And then if you notice the More button, I can tap it all I want, but it won't be active. So these are the new features of the properties we have for each button. Proloquo2Go 2.0 and later also lets you display certain folders as a grid or list view. Depending on a folder, a list can be helpful in arranging a schedule or a to-do list. So let's navigate into school. And if we go into edit, we can tap on views now. Now if we go and select view type, we can actually change it to a list view. Go back into the school folder, you can see that everything is still in grid view. But if we go back into the schedule, you'll see that it's now in a list view. Also under the view tab, we can change each page button colors, so it applies to all of them on that page. Or we can change the button display, so we just want the images. Or we can change it so that all we see is the label of the buttons. Also in the edit mode, we're able to reorder buttons in the list view quickly just by going into edit mode. And then tapping on the three bars and holding down, and now we can move it and arrange it any order we want. Well, that's covering most of the new edit features. All the other ones we'll be covering in other tutorial videos.